Namaskar, I am Dr. Hemant Kalra. I am a pulmonologist. Today I'll be talking about a very rare disease in respiratory medicine called pulmonary artery hypertension. Before I tell you about this disease, I must tell you about the normal circulation in our body. In normal circulation, blood from all parts of the body enters the right side of the heart. Blood from the right side of the heart then enters the numerous tiny vessels in both the lungs. These vessels take up oxygen from the environment. This blood, which is full of oxygen, then enters the left side of the heart, and then the left side of the heart pumps this blood full of oxygen to all parts of the body. So what happens in pulmonary artery hypertension? In pulmonary artery hypertension, the pressure in the pulmonary arteries is increased. Pulmonary arteries carry blood from the right side of the heart through the lungs. In this disease, the pulmonary arteries become narrow and stiff, so that there is less volume for blood to flow through. This results in lower oxygen level throughout the body. Pulmonary artery hypertension is a specific form of pulmonary hypertension, because pulmonary hypertension is a general term that means higher pressure in the arteries of the lung that affect the right side of the heart. But there are other causes of pulmonary hypertension. We classify pulmonary hypertension into five categories. First is pulmonary artery hypertension. Second is pulmonary hypertension because of diseases affecting the left side of the heart. Third, pulmonary hypertension secondary to diseases of the lungs. Fourth, pulmonary hypertension because of clots in the lungs. And fifth, pulmonary hypertension because of other miscellaneous disorders like kidney disease and sarcoidosis. So what are the symptoms in pulmonary artery hypertension? Most of the symptoms are non-specific, because these symptoms can be seen in other conditions also. Most common symptoms are shortness of breath, exertional breathlessness, fatigue, dizziness, fainting, and chest pain. These are the common symptoms in pulmonary artery hypertension. So, who develop pulmonary artery hypertension? It is seen in all ages and genders. Most of the cases are idiopathic, that is, there is no identifiable cause. Second is heritable, that is, genetic PAH. One or more members in the family have PAH. Third, it is associated with diet pills, people who take appetite suppressant drugs. Fourth, in people with HIV, who are infected with HIV. Fifth, in liver disorders. And last, in scleroderma. So all ages and genders can be affected in pulmonary artery hypertension. So how to diagnose pulmonary artery hypertension? It is very difficult to diagnose pulmonary artery hypertension in routine clinical examinations, because most of the symptoms are non-specific and the disease is also very rare. So a high index of suspicion is required to diagnose pulmonary artery hypertension. So your doctor may advise a battery of tests, including ECG, X-ray, pulmonary function test, HRCT, 2D echo, 6-minute walk test, ventilation perfusion scan, and a battery of blood tests like kidney function test, liver function test, thyroid function test, NT-proBNP, and HIV tests to rule out pulmonary artery hypertension. So what is the treatment of pulmonary artery hypertension? There are three classes of drugs available to treat pulmonary artery hypertension. First is prostaglandins, second is endothelial receptor antagonist, and the third is phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors. Prostaglandins, we do not have it in India, but yes, it is available in West and European countries. Initially, it was available in injectable form, then came the inhalation form, then a tablet is also available for the treatment of pulmonary artery hypertension. In endothelial receptor antagonist category, we have got three drugs: bosentan, ambrisentan, and mesitentan. We have got all the three drugs available in India. Last is phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors. We have got two drugs, sildenafil and tadalafil, available in India for the treatment of pulmonary artery hypertension. A very similar drug called riosuGOAT is also available in India. It is very similar to phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors that can also be used to treat selected cases of pulmonary artery hypertension. Your doctor will decide whether you need one drug or two drugs or three drugs in combination. So what more can be done to improve quality of life? First, vaccination is mandatory for influenza and pneumococcal pneumonia vaccine. Second, you have to stay active. Pulmonary rehabilitation is a great method to improve quality of life. Third, stop smoking and alcohol intake. Fourth, regular visit to your chest specialist doctor. Fifth, treat modifiable or comorbid conditions like heart failure and sleep apnea. And last and very important is take oxygen if required and recommended by your doctor. So, pulmonary artery hypertension is a rare disease. High index of clinical suspicion is required to diagnose it. Most of the drugs available in the West are available in India. So, patients of pulmonary artery hypertension can lead a very good life and improve their quality of life with the drugs available and other supportive therapy like vaccination, pulmonary rehabilitation, and oxygen.